In June, EU member states had already committed $72 billion in support for Ukraine. On top of that, we have the $50 billion Ukraine facility and the proposed $20 billion Ukraine assistance fund for military equipment. All going to plan, by December the EU will have committed $142 billion, $100 from the budget, to keeping the war going, its fallout and the reconstruction. Not to mention the cost of inflation from promoting the same war. The EU's decades of neoliberal capitalism have seen public services decimated, inequality rise and public spending lowered. These policies have contributed to a crisis in housing, healthcare, transport, labour conditions, cost of living and the environment. Yet, the EU's priorities are security and defence. We need a housing and infrastructure revolution, but instead we're maxing out the budget on handouts to the defence sector and incentives for disaster capitalists. You can't keep serving the elites at the expense of the people. Reconstruction of Ukraine will cost more than $1 trillion. How much of that are the EU taxpayers going to pay?
This has been the Nod News Network, transmission complete.